Good evening, everybody. I'm Bella. This is the news and the weather, presented in English and Portuguese. News about what's happened in Martha's Vineyard. News from Brazil as well. Here is our show. Martha's Vineyard Community Service will open a new clinic on May 22nd to dispense a drug that has helped many people to escape the grip of addiction to heroin and other opioids. The clinic is located in a refurbished building on the Community Service campus in Oak Bluffs. We'll dispense the drug sold under the brand name Suboxone. Martha's Vineyard Community Service vai abrir uma nova clínica em 22 de maio para fornecer a droga Suboxone, que ajudou muitas pessoas a escapar do controle do vício em heroína e outros opioides. A nova clínica, localizada em um prédio reformado no campus da Community Service em Oak Bluffs, vai fornecer um medicamento vendido sob a marca Suboxone. Suboxone is a combination of the generic drug naloxone, the same drug in Narcan, used to revive overdose victims, and the synthetic opioid buprenorphine. While controversial in some quarters, Suboxone is considered a less risk alternative to heroin. According with the Vineyard Gazette story, people who use the drug in combination with physiotherapy often say they are able to function well and lead normal lives. Suboxone é uma combinação do medicamento genérico naloxone, o mesmo medicamento usado em Narcan, usado para reviver vítimas de overdose, e do opioide sintético buprenorfina. Embora controversial em alguns setores, o Suboxone é considerado uma alternativa menos arriscada à heroína. De acordo com o jornal Vineyard Gazette, as pessoas que usam a droga em combinação com a psicoterapia costumam dizer que são capazes de funcionar bem e levar uma vida normal. Suboxone has been available on Martha's Vineyard for several years, but doctors who prescribed it did not accept insurance reimbursement. O Suboxone está disponível em Martha's Vineyard há vários anos, mas os médicos que o prescrevia não aceitavam o reembolso do seguro. A clínica em Martha's Vineyard Community Service aceitará seguro, tornando a droga mais amplamente disponível na ilha. The clinic at Martha's Vineyard Community Service will accept insurance, make the drug more widely available on the island. Circulando! Tisbury votes narrowly reject the $46.6 million new school project. Os eleitores de Tisbury rejeitaram o novo projeto escolar de $46.6 million. The project for the construction of a new Tisbury school was heavily debated and was widely approved at the city's annual meeting in the second week of April, but was rejected by 21 votes at the city's last annual meeting on Tuesday, the 24 April. Tisbury voters reject a debt-free issue from proposition 2.5567546, a margin of 20 votes. I think this second part is extra, but let's keep with this. O projeto para a construção de uma nova escola Tisbury foi muito debatido e obteve aprovação por ampla margem na reunião anual da cidade na segunda semana de abril, mas logo foi rejeitado por 21 votos na última reunião anual da cidade na terça-feira, no dia 24 de abril. Os eleitores de Tisbury rejeitaram uma questão de isenção de dívida da proposição 2 NRF, uma margem de 21 votos. The proposed project called for building a new 76,000 square foot school on the existing site while housing students in the old 1929 brick school during construction before eventually demolishing that building. The town was eligible to receive $14.6 million in state reimbursement money by Massachusetts School Building Authority for the past years to develop the plan for the project, leaving taxpayers responsible for $32 million. O projeto proposto seria para a construção de uma nova escola de 76 mil pés quadrados no local existente. E durante a construção, os estudantes continuariam a utilizar o prédio da antiga escola, datado de 1929, antes dele ser demolido. A cidade foi elegível para receber 14,6 milhões de reembolso estadual da Autoridade de Construção Escolar de Massachusetts para o projeto, deixando os contribuintes responsáveis por $32 million. Some voters were disappointed with the ballot results, but other voters felt differently and were concerned about the impact on property taxes, and they believe the old school should be renovated, not demolished. Alguns eleitores ficaram desapontados com os resultados das urnas, mas outros eleitores se sentiram diferentes e estavam preocupados com o impacto nos impostos sobre a propriedade. Alguns deles dizem que a antiga escola deveria ser reformada e não demolida. The school question has been divided the town and dominated community discussion for months. A questão da escola dividiu a cidade e dominou a discussão da comunidade por meses. Os próximos passos ainda não estão claros. The next steps remain unclear. Will you learn more? Total turnout on the ballot was 1,120, about 32% of 3,529 registered voters in town. O comparecimento total nas urnas foi de 1.120 pessoas, cerca de 32% dos 3.529 eleitores registrados na cidade. We were there, nós estávamos lá, on the Spring Gala 1854, a folk opera, fundraiser, silent auction, live music and refreshments, no evento de gala de primavera para arrecadação de fundos para a produção da ópera popular 1854. Com leilão silencioso, música ao vivo e refrescos e entrevista exclusiva com Jim Thomas, o fundador e presidente do projeto US Slave Song, falando sobre a história de 1854. Watch now! Exclusive interview with Jim Thomas, founder and president of US Slave Song Project. Talk about 1854, a folk opera. Assista agora, watch now.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, Bella.
Please tell us a little bit about this beautiful event.
This event is celebrating the startup of 1854, a folk opera. And it will open hopefully with a concert version this September. We hope to do it at Union Chapel, and we will have then the full production available next September. But this will be like a community test this fall. It's a marvelous story about the vineyard and a town meeting that was held in 1854. It was to pass a vote on whether or not to end slavery in the United States. And it was there because the House of Representatives in Washington, D.C. had passed a law stating that they would no longer consider any laws concerning slavery at all. And the local citizens said, oh no, this cannot be. And they would not support that. So the entire story is about all of that evolved around the discussions for that, leading up to a vote at the end.
Jim Thomas also is a director of the Spiritual Chorus in Martha's Vineyard. Jim Thomas é também o diretor do coro espiritual de Martha's Vineyard. Watch Part 2, interview with Jim Thomas. Exciting.
When the story begins, there are small children hiding out in the theater because their parents are going to be there, and they're hiding. They don't want them to see them and catch them, but the children have heard that this will be an historic meeting, and they want to be a part of it. And there will be all sorts of music that will go, about 20 songs that will be included, or parts of those songs at least. And since it is a folk opera, this means that there are some traditional melodies that will be sung. And there will be three different types of songs. One will be sea shanties, songs from the sea. Imagine that, coming from the vineyard, because of the whaling that was going on during those days. And the fugitive slaves that came here wanted to find work on the whaling ships. And so there is a scene with mariners that will sing sea shanties. The townspeople will sing traditional type songs like Psalms 23 from the Bible. Then there will be constant singing of the Freedom Chorus that will sort of set the mood for the different scenes within the opera. It's tremendous.
Thank you. Thank you for putting this so positive for us.
You're welcome.
1854, a folk opera traz a comunidade Martha's Vineyard mais conhecimento de sua própria cultura. And contact is U.S. slavesongproject.com/about/. Thank you, Lauren Andrade, Jim Thomas, Carol Loud, and Martha's Vineyard Community. 1854, a folk opera, will bring to the Martha's Vineyard community more knowledge on its own culture. E now, news from Brazil, notícias do Brasil. Esta é a matéria sugerida por Solo Mascarenhas para o nosso programa. A história é de Caio Quero e Felipe Souza, da BBC Brasil, em São Paulo, do dia 26 de abril. Boulos diz que não é possível governar para todos. O mercado que tome Retrovil. Retrovil é um medicamento para conter a doença de pânico e outros tipos de estresse, de sofrimentos. O líder do Movimento dos Trabalhadores Sem Teto, o MTST, Guilherme Boulos, de 35 anos, quer se tornar o presidente da República mais novo da história do Brasil. Pré-candidato pelo PSOL, ele tem ao seu favor um movimento social de expressão e uma espécie de unção feita por Lula em seu último discurso em 7 de abril. Boulos faz parte de um partido pequeno e não passa de 1% das intenções de voto, segundo o último levantamento do Instituto Datafolha. Em entrevista à BBC Brasil, o pré-candidato afirmou que é impossível governar para toda a população brasileira e que, caso eleito, combaterá os privilégios da população mais rica. A matéria da BBC diz que Boulos defende consultas à população sobre temas fundamentais. Isto não é desvalorizar as instituições, ao contrário, é valorizar as instituições, porque é isto que vai fazer com que elas estejam em sintonia com a sociedade. For your understand the leader of the workers' homeless movement, Guilherme Boulos, 35 years old, wants to become the newest, youngest Guilherme Boulos, president of Brazil history. Guilherme Boulos is a nominee for the PSOL party, has in his favor a social movement of expression and a kind of unction made by ex-Brazil President Lula, who praised him in his last speech on April 7 this year. Boulos is part of a small party and only 1% of the voting intentions, according to the latest survey by the Datafolha Institute. In an interview with BBC Brazil, the nominee Guilherme Boulos said that it is impossible to govern for the entire Brazilian population, and that if elected, he will combat the privilege of the richest population. In the BBC story, Boulos defends public consultations on key issues. This is not to devalue institutions, on the contrary, because that is what will make institutions in harmony with society. With a middle-class background, Guilherme Boulos is the son of one of the country's leading infectious diseases, Dr. Marcos Boulos, coordinator of disease control at the Health Department of the São Paulo government. Boulos said that it's not possible to govern for everyone, make everyone happy. The market must take Pepto-Bismol. I just exchanged the name, Retroview in Brazil. Pepto-Bismol, a medicine for stomach and other types of distress. Okay, Boulos, good luck. Well, and here, the weather forecast in the scene, yellow, a bright color. It is all over Martha's Vineyard, na cena primaveril, o amarelo que está por toda parte em Martha's Vineyard. Daffodils and four cynthias everywhere. Here is the weather forecast for this week. Here we go, aqui vamos nós. In English and Portuguese, em inglês em português. Tonight, Monday, hoje, noite segunda-feira, scattering showers mainly before 9 p.m. with a low around 42. Northwest wind, chuvas esparsas, principalmente antes das 21 horas, com mínimas em torno de 42 graus e ventos pelo noroeste. Tuesday, terça-feira, mostly sunny, with a high near 57, southwest wind, 8 to 11 miles per hour. Terça-feira com sol e com as máximas nos 57 graus, Os ventos virão pelo sudoeste entre 8 a 11 milhas por hora. For Tuesday night, partly cloud with a low around 49, southwest wind around 11 miles per hour. Para a noite de terça-feira, um pouquinho de frio, com a temperatura caindo para os 49 graus. Wednesday sunny with a high near 74, southwest wind 11 to 18 miles per hour. Dia de sol na quarta, com máximas nos 74. Wednesday night, na noite quarta-feira, partly cloud with a low around 53. Tempo parcialmente nublado para quarta-noite, também parcialmente nublado na quinta-feira. Thursday, partly sunny with a high near 67. Thursday night, noite quinta-feira, mostly cloud with a low around 56. Tempo nublado com a temperatura mínima ficando 56 graus. Friday, sexta-feira, mostly cloud with a high near 64. Breeze. O tempo vai continuar nublado e as máximas vão subir para os 64 graus, uma pequena brisa. Como também vai continuar nublado na noite de sexta. On Friday night, mostly cloud with a low around 54. Breeze. Welcome, Mayflowers. Positive for Open Mic every other Tuesday. Duas terças-feiras ao mês, de 5 a 7 da noite. Open Mic, próximo Open Mic, dia 8 de maio. Terça-feira na Island Music em Vinnie Haven. Let's go there. 5 de maio. 5 de maio. Stay positive for concurso Big Chili. The Big Chili Contest. We do not have a poster for that, but we love the chili. This Saturday, May 5th. 5 de maio at the Portuguese American Club. PA Club. Alpacas! Aconteceu em Martha's Vineyard. Happening in Martha's Vineyard. The 11th annual Sharing Day Open House. This event features some of the area's finest alpacas. More than 50 alpacas were scheduled for sharing and public viewing. Mais de 50 alpacas foram programadas para corte e visualização pública na fazenda das alpacas no último sábado. E você, Michelle Vivian, qual é a sua mensagem? What's your message, Michelle Vivian?
My message today is the message of the griot, and the griot is the storyteller in a play that is called 1854. They will find the actress that's going to play this role very soon, and they are trying to look for funding, and so I am here to help personalize and imagine the actual griot.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
It's so special.
Thank you for always telling the right stories.
Thanks to Ulcers, the National Weather, Lynn Christopher's beautiful image background, MVTV special thanks to Carl Holt, Martha's Vineyard Savings Bank, Martha's Vineyard Cultural Council and Chronics Market. Thank you all for all your support. Contact us at Planet Bella at hotmail.com. Plus, we are on Facebook. Follow us and like us on Facebook. Connect with us on Facebook and Planet Bella TV on YouTube channel. The news and the weather with Bella is connecting communities since 2014. Flexibility. It's a gift. Open, very careful, and enjoy it. A flexibilidade é um presente. Abra-o devagar e desfrute dele. Tchau, tchau, for now. Next.